This podcast is brought to you by Australia's LGBTQIA+ community media organisation, Joy. Keep Joy on air by becoming a member, a subscriber, or donate. Head to joy.org.au. Joy, a diverse sound for a diverse community.
Worldwide Wrap, LGBT news from around the world, scanning the globe for stories for the diverse gay and lesbian communities from Australia's Joy 94.9. This is the Worldwide Wrap.
And tonight we start in China. So there's been a lot of discussion about China lately, but that's a little bit of a surprising one. Amongst the fears of government crackdown on the LGBT, the whole thing about, you know, being too feminine if you're a man
or
a boy, yeah, it's all this. They've opened a very first gender clinic for trans youth. So the clinic was set up at the Children's Hospital of Fudan University in Shanghai, and so it includes psychology, urology, endocrine, genetic, metabolic department. So everything that is needed. So they were already treating patient, a transgender patient there, and just wanting to put everything under the same roof, really. Trying to improve teenagers' mood, mental health, prescribe medication to stop menstruation.
It sounds like they might even just be listening to the health professionals. Maybe this is a whole COVID thing of, oh my gosh, the health professionals have said something. Because there was a study in 2019 in China that found trans students in most parts of the world had higher rates of anxiety and depression. And the Global Times, which is run, the media outlet run by the Communist Party, circulated that. So there's obviously recognition that there's... that it is a live issue.
Yeah, it is. But the LGBTI plus activists are still happy, but very surprised, because it comes, as I said at the beginning, it comes amid the fears of crackdown on this TV restrictions, also the gaming, the wiping out LGBTI plus accounts, Shanghai Pride just stopping operation with no reason. So it's... Yes, not.
There have been lots of bad stories. So this is perhaps the...
bad little things that add up to a lot.
Bit hard to tell what the narrative there is in the Chinese government at the moment. We need some good news, Shannon.
Yes, so I am taking us to India this evening. So for the first time, the Supreme Court Collegium has recommended the elevation of an openly gay member of the judiciary to the bench. So they've recommended senior advocate Saurabh Kapal, who was actually originally recommended unanimously in 2017, but they deferred it four times. I wonder why.
Sounds like the same deferrals for Section 377, their sodomy laws that kept going backwards and forth
and
in India.
But then March this year, so, 7-8 months ago, time is flying, the Chief Justice... asked the government to make an official clear stance. And they did. And he is now going to be elevated to the Supreme, to the High Court, sorry.
And he's got such a tremendous record as well.
Yes.
He has served on the Supreme Court for over two decades, served on the United Nations. He was actually a lawyer for petitioners in the very first case that led to the scrapping of Section 377, the infamous colonial era sodomy laws. So he's clearly got the credentials for this.
Yeah,
job.
Yeah. And he did say that, like, last year, that he believes it's been deferred so many times because of his sexuality. But now he's been elevated.
And perhaps that visibility will inspire others to break that ceiling and push on further as well. Alex, across to Russia.
Yes, and look, everyone put on their surprise face that I've got a story from Russia that's not overly positive. So a prominent Russian LGBT plus group working to evacuate queer people from Chechnya, very on topic for our theme tonight, has been added to the Russian Ministry of Justice's list of foreign agents. Now, what this means is that they are required to, they're going to be under additional government scrutiny. Once registered, such groups are subject then to audits, forced to mark all their official statements with a disclosure that has been given by a foreign agent. I mean, this is the Russian.
It sounds very they're terrorist type thing.
Well, that's if you go, you know, you read further into this, it's again the standard fallbacks of all populist governments, which is to basically say that this is seen as a foreign influence. These sorts of organizations, again, echoes we've seen in Africa, again, various countries that we've looked at where this is a standard default defense, and national security. We hear this so many times. Obviously, this group rejects this categorization outright and says it's just an attempt again. And Amnesty have come out and says it's beyond shameful, they've claimed. So,
they are a resilient lot, though. They will fight on.
Yes.
Across to the USA now, where a unique one-time treatment for HIV has been given the green light to begin human trials by the US FDA, the Food and Drug Administration. It's basically a drug that edits the gene. It's called CRISPR. And it could potentially function as a treatment for HIV by cutting out several pieces of the HIV genome in this one-time treatment. So it's not a cure.
Oh, okay.
But what it does, instead of doing an ongoing treatment of antiretroviral therapies, it means you've got a one-off treatment. It changes the gene so that the that HIV does not replicate and you essentially become undetectable. So it's going into human trials. So they've hit that first milestone, and we'll be able to see in the years to come if that is a new treatment for HIV.
How is that different from current antiretrovirals?
Well, it's one-off as opposed to ongoing drug treatments.
So
we'll keep an eye on that one, because that's a wrap.
That's your Worldwide Wrap. Keep up with LGBT news from around the world throughout the week. Like us on Facebook, Worldwide Wave, or visit joy.org.au/worldwidewave.
Thanks for listening to another Joy podcast brought to you by Australia's LGBTQIA+ community media organisation, Joy. Help us keep Joy on air. Head to joy.org.au. Joy, a diverse sound for a diverse community.